I think it's a big mistake. I think the governor does not realize what he's getting himself into. E-Verify, first of all, has a lot of problems in the system. It's a very old system. There have been lots of cases of U.S. citizens losing their jobs because they are not on the E-Verify in the system. And so a lot of people have spent years trying to get back on and showing that they are U.S. citizens. So the system itself is broken. But in addition to that, it's a no-win situation. It's not good for employers, because a lot of employers are now going to be very afraid to hire people, and the employers are going to be targeted and be afraid of getting fines and even getting possible jail time for hiring people that they've been hiring for years. It's bad for workers, because there have been workers that are undocumented that have been in their jobs for 10, 15, 20, and 30 years. Why in the world would we want to target people who are doing some of the hardest work in this country that other people don't do? Why would we want to target them and threaten them with job loss? And it's no win for the economy of the state, because the economy of the state depends on undocumented workers as well. They are cleaning your hotel rooms. They are landscaping your yard. They are harvesting the vegetables that we eat every day. They are putting roofs on your house. They are building houses and building housing developments all across the state. It's terrible for the economy, and it's also terrible for human rights, because workers that are supposedly or potentially displaced because of E-Verify are going to have to work someplace. And where are they going to go? Are they going to move to other states? A lot of people cannot afford to move to other states, so they're going to go into an underground economy where they're going to be exploited, even worse, by unscrupulous bosses that will put them in really horrible conditions. We have lots of cases of wage theft at the Farmworker Association because of unscrupulous subcontractors that will hire people and then not pay them and threaten them because they're undocumented. I just don't understand how anybody who cares about human rights and who cares about families and children would consider doing something like this that has the potential to really damage families and people's livelihoods and their home life. I mean, we're in the middle of inflation right now. It's hard enough for people to be able to afford their rent, to be able to afford their food, just basics, school supplies for their kids, and now you're going to talk about wanting to potentially have them lose their jobs because you want to implement the E-Verify program. This is going to cause a major, we already have a homeless problem in the state. We're going to create a bigger homeless problem? I mean, where are people going to go? Our homeless shelters are filled. We're going to end up just making more homeless people, or having multiple people in a single house or apartment, or people are going to have to move from the state. And if the governor thinks that that's what is the best solution, then let him see what it's like when we don't have people here to do the jobs that we all depend on every single day. People aren't aware of it, but there are undocumented people in your life every day, and not just, you know, cleaning hotel rooms, but they are academics, they are in tech industry, they are in all kinds of industries. This is opening up a horrible can of worms that's going to end up being detrimental to the state and our economy and our families and our entire the entire state. So it's a lose-lose situation all the way around. Well, I will say I think it's ironic that we're targeting immigrants that do some of the hardest work, and yet we let others off the hook that are doing corporate crimes. We're not going after people that do corporate crimes. We have a small tax base because we got rid of the capital gains tax years ago. So why are we targeting some of the people that do some of the hardest work in our country that are here to just have solid families? There is a myth that needs to be dispelled, because the myth is saying that immigrants are doing the crimes and are so-called illegal, and statistics show that immigrants are doing less crimes than the citizens. If you look at some of the crimes that have been going on around the state, it's not from undocumented immigrants. They're very few, but they choose just those few bad people that are doing some of these crimes, and they lift those up and they're not showcasing all the hundreds of thousands of people in this state and in this country who are doing hard work and completely following the laws legally and supporting their families and contributing to this economy by paying taxes and being a part of our society and our communities and doing work in our schools and for our children. It's ridiculous to target the people who are least contributing to the problems in this state.